several laps to get temperature in these Michelin tires, and we're back at it. What does Grant have for Kranz down at turn one this time? Is he going to go try to go around the outside? No, he's not. A little further back.
Whoa!
There we go.
Battle for fifth and a spin. Oh, and contact, big time contact. Joe Robillard got into him just as he was spun around, and three or four cars involved now.
Yeah, we were just talking about Joe Robillard and Stephen McAleer hopefully having a good day. I think that one has come to an end with the 47 in the back and one of the junior three entries, the number three involved as well. It was the 34 that had the initial spin.
Peter Ludwig.
And Robillard actually up in the air.
Down on the inside, Brian. Oh, he wanted to go. Yeah. The car in front was not.
He jumped back in the throttle, made contact, and when he made that contact, he had to lift. And as soon as he lifted, that transfers weight to the front, gives the front end good grip. The rear end comes around because you're already compromised. You're in the corner already. And now you've got, you're sitting in the mouth of the funnel and everybody else is coming in. Take a look.
Tristan Herbert just gets a little wiggly in the green, black, and white car. And when Ludwig wanted to jump back in the gas, there was no place to go. Brian, how do teams look at a situation like this? There is a championship. It's a six-race championship. It's not the same level as, let's say, the... Oh, my goodness. And now Dan Goldberg is in the barrier. Hang on. Let's hold that previous thought. And Dan's going to hop out.
Yeah.
This went from questionable to a whole lot worse. And waving to the crowd there. There are a few fans on the grounds today. Yep, he's looking at it like, what in the world just happened?
You know what? And I love race fans. That's impressive right there on the part of Tristan Herbert. This Andretti Autosport team just got the car.
Oh, look out!
And that.
And Naveen Rao takes the one too far into the International Horseshoe and takes out both himself and Herbert.
And that was not impressive. We were just talking about what was. Well, now we can talk about what isn't. Now it's going to be difficult to get these cars back underway. And had a good look at both sides of the car since they've been spinning around in circles there. They don't seem to have a lot of damage on them. But I wonder, brake zone, but the opportunity just isn't there. Herbert's already turned in to enter the corner, and Rao has way too much speed. I don't think if Herbert was there, Rao was going to make the corner anyway.
No. And he wasn't certainly crowding the apex. But
they're laying down lap times and pulling away right now from us. They're about a second quicker every lap. The sooner we could get Dakota in, the more experienced driver, maybe we could close into that.
And Herbert getting ready to get back onto the banking, thinking of making a move. It looks like he's trying to get and overcooks it.
Yeah, that little move to the left kind of gets down to the inside. No harm, no foul.
And then
up, but we're going to get some experience. We're going to get some mileage. And we're going to get some points, like we talked about.
That's right. Trent Hindman waiting on deck to take over the seven. And around goes Olsen. Hamilton will finally find his way by, but a mistake by the driver of the 86. We'll give them that opportunity. I wonder how much pressure was coming from behind with Bryn Olsen there.
It's the incident, because I'm sure the spotters on the radio say, no, you know, you got to go. People are coming. And he just gets it around. And you're like, well, how does he do that? They have traction control. Well, traction control is all well and good, but
number one, we had an off recently, Brian. That's the 86 around. Yes, he did go around, it appears.
Yeah.
But where did the flat?